relations between tight side tension, slack side tension and coefficient of friction between belt and pulley and angle of lap. Today we will solve the problem about last class. Today we will solve a problem based on last class. So what is the question? Now find the power transmitted by a belt running over a pulley of 600 mm diameter at 200 rpm. The coefficient of friction between belt and pulley is 0.25 and angle of lap is 160 degree and maximum tension in belt is 2500 newton. So basically he is asking about power transmitted. First, before when we will solve a problem, first we will write the given data. What is the given data? Now diameter of pulley. Diameter of pulley D equals to 600 mm and L. Revolutions of the pulley or RPM is 200 mm, 200 RPM. N is 200 RPM. The coefficient of friction between belt and pulley is given 0.25. Means mu is 0.25 and angle of lap is 160 degree. Means what is the angle subtended by the belt at the center of the pulley? That means theta equals to 160 degree. And last is given maximum tension in belt is 2500 newton. Maximum tension means tension in the tight side. Means T1 is given. T1 is 2500 newton. Now they are asking about power. Find the power transmitted. So we know in belt drive, but belt drive power transmitted is the T1 minus T2 into V. We know this formula, T1 minus T2 into V. But in this given data, we have given T1, but we don't know value of T2 and V. But we don't know value of T2 and V. So first we will find the value of T2 and then V. Then we will calculate the power. So finding, how we will find this T2? How we will find this value of T2? Now the by the relation T1 by T2 equals to e to the power mu theta. By using this formula, we can calculate T2. So first we will calculate the value of T2. Tension in slack side. Tension in slack side, we already know. T1 by T2 equals to e to the power mu theta. In this formula, we have already told we have to put theta value in radian, but here theta value is given in degree. So we have to convert this degree to radian. So we know 180 degree equals to pi radian. We know 180 degree equals to pi radian. So 1 degree equals to pi by 180 radian. But here theta is given 160 degree. So 160 degree equals to pi by 180 into 160 radian. Pi by 180 into 160 radian. So this 0 is 0, 16 by 18 pi radian. So theta value is 16 by 18 pi radian. So we can write here theta equals to 16 by 18 pi radian. So 16 by 18 pi radian. So here we know theta value mu T1. So we have to calculate T2. So by putting again T1 by T2 equals to e to the power mu theta. Here T1 is the tension in tight side. Tension in the tight side is given 2500 newton. Tension in the tight side is given 2500 newton divided by T2. then e to the power mu theta, mu is given, mu the coefficient of friction, mu is given 0.25, e to the power 0.25 into theta, theta value we have to put, theta value in radians, so theta equals to 16 by 18 pi radians, 16 by 18 pi radians, so 2500 by T2, this value is e to the power 0.25 into 16 by 18, this value is 2.01. By solving this e to the power 0.25 into 16 by 18 pi, this value is 2.01. This value is 2.01, so we have to calculate this T2. So T2 equals to 2500 divided by 2.01. 2500 divided by 2.01, so this value is 1244 newton, because here T1 is given in newton, so T2 is the tension in the slag side, we have obtained T2 value, T2 equals to 1244 newton. So for calculating power we required three values, T1, T2 and velocity. We calculated already, T1 is given, T2 calculated, so then second we have to calculate the velocity of the belt, so V. We have to calculate V. We know angular velocity omega equals to V by R. Angular velocity equals to V by R. V1 is the linear velocity, R is the radius of the pulley. So V equals to omega into R. We know omega equals to 2 pi n by 60 into R. So these two R, this is pi into 2R. These two R, we can write 2R in place of 2R, we can write D. So pi into 2R into n by 60. So pi into D into n by 60. So we will get the formula for calculating the velocity of the belt. So velocity of the belt equals to pi D n by 60. The belt velocity formula is pi D n by 60. Already n is given in RPM. So D, we have to calculate D. D is given 600 mm, but we have to calculate this in n in RPM. So n in RPM, n by 60, so RPS. So D, we have to calculate this, and we have to convert this mm into meter. So 600 divided by 1000, that is 0.6 meter. So 0.6 meter, by putting the all the values, this is pi, this D is 0.6, this D is 0.6, n is 200 rpm, n is 200 rpm divided by 60, we will get the value 6.284 meter per second. If we detail the mm to meter, we convert to the relative velocity of mm per second. But we required meter per second, so 6 into 284 meter per second. Thus, velocity of belt is 6.284 meter per second. But we are asking about power. What is the power transmitted? We already know the formula for power transmission. P equals to T1 minus T2 into V. T1 minus T2 into V. So T1 is already given 2500 newton. T1 is already given 2500 newton. T2, we have calculated the value of T2. T2 value is, we have calculated now, 1244 newton into V. This is the velocity of belt. Velocity of belt equals to 6.284 meter in meter per second. 6.284 meter per second. By calculating this, power is obtained as, this is 7.889 kilowatt.
So this is the final answer, the 7.89 kilowatt.
7.89 kilowatt. So pochatla kona na find the power transmitted. The power ami kemiti transmit kala na power transmit kore pa ami already formula dam jodi diye gete na T1 minus T2 into V. T1 is already given. T1 is 2500 newton. So we have to first we have to calculate T2 and V. So how we will calculate T2 and V? Last class we have studied the relation T1 by T2 equals to e to the power mu theta by calculating e to the power mu theta. So there T1 is given, mu is given, theta is given, but theta is given in degree. But in that relation we have to put the value of theta in radian. We will already discuss how to convert degree into radian. So theta is 16 by 18 pi radian. We will convert theta into 16 by 18 pi radian by calculating, by putting all the values in T1 by T2 equals to e to the power mu theta. We have calculated the value of T2 is 1244 newton. Again, we need one data, that is velocity of the bend for calculating power. How we will calculate velocity of the bend? We know angular velocity. We know the relation between angular velocity and linear velocity. Angular velocity equals to V by R. So V equals to omega into R, or angular velocity to R. What we already know, angular velocity omega equals to 2 pi n by 16 into R. This 2R is, we can replace this 2R by D, diameter of the pulley. Pi into 2R, 2R into n by 60. So pi D n by 60. We got the formula for calculating the velocity of the belt. So pi into D. Here we will convert the mm into meter so that we can get the formula in meter per second. In SI unit, pi into d, that is 0.6 into 200 rpm divided by 60, we will get 6.284 meter per second. We will get the value, velocity of the belt, 6.284 meter per second. Then finally we will get T1, T2 and V by putting the value P equals to T1 minus T2 into V. T1 in place of T1, that has given 2500 newton. We are calculating 1244 newton in place of T2, and all we calculate the velocity of the belt is 6.284 meter per second. By placing 6.284 meter per second, we will get the answer 7.89 kilowatts.